daughter. So they kind of, they teamed up together. Very, very cool.
Yeah.
I know how to play the guitar.
Do you? Well, me too.
Me too. He's in a band.
Awesome. Yeah. Nothing like it, right? It's the best in the world to sit and play guitar.
No, it's more like
a horn. Oh, okay. Well, we're going to change that because after we finish, I'm going to teach you Keith Richards' favorite song, okay, which happens to be someone else's favorite Rolling Stones song, too. Okay? So let's do this. Let's finish the book, and then if you have any questions or comments after the book, we will have some chit chat. You gotta be patient, dear. Can you fork it? Thanks. Okay, this book is called Gus and Me. The story of my granddad and my first guitar.
John?
Theodore Augustus Dupree lived with his seven daughters near the Seven Sisters Road in a house that was filled with instruments and cake. Theodore Augustus Dupree could play the piano and scrape the violin, blow the saxophone, strum the guitar. He had been a soldier, a baker, and a leader of a dance
band.
But now, Theodore Augustus Dupree was my granddad. Now he was Gus. There was nothing like visiting Gus. The closer to his house I'd get, the bigger my smile would grow. By the time I landed on his doorstep, I was all teeth. He'd be waiting at the front door for me. "Fix the sink, Gus," my grandmother would call out. "Can't do, Emma," Gus would call back. "Keith and I are going for a walk." He'd wink at me and whistle for Mr. Thompson Woofed, and our adventure would begin. We'd walk for miles, we'd walk through towns, and we'd walk through the countryside. And Gus, he would hum every step of the way. He'd hum whole symphonies as we strolled from the village to the next. He'd hum funny little tunes as we wandered. Skinny streets and smoky alleys, marching songs as it tiptoed around foggy ponds and explored silent forests.
Why are you looking at me?
Because you're so pretty. With Gus, you had no idea where you'd end up. One time, he led me all the way to the top of Primrose Hill to look at the night stars. "Don't know if we can make it home tonight," Gus said. So we slept under a tree on the top of the hill with the sky lights above and the city lights below. Once Gus walked us all the way to London and into the workshop of his big store that sold instruments. "Let's just pop in here. I gotta pick up some strings," said Gus. Inside, it looked like a beehive.
Gus lifted me up and sat me on the shelf so that I could see everything. Violins hung from the ceiling by wires. Horns clung to the walls. Men in long brown coats fixed broken instruments and built new ones. I watched as they bent over cellos, trombones, and trumpets. They dabbled at the drums with glue and tapped at them with tiny hammers. Men tested the guitar strings. Dinka-plink, a dinka-plink. My eyes followed a line of guitars that snaked around the room on a conveyor belt in the middle of everything. Big, bubbling buckets of glue went through. It was magic. I sat on the shelf watching it all. And right then, right there, I fell in love with instruments. When Gus and I got back to his house that day, I took a long look at that guitar that always sat on the top of his piano. It seemed more beautiful than ever. All I wanted was to make the strings go. All I wanted to do was make the strings go. But I couldn't reach it. When you're tall enough, you can have a go, Gus said. Every time I visited Gus, I reached for that guitar, even on my toes. One day, I felt like I was tall enough to grab it. But I didn't even have to try. Gus simply handed it to me. All yours, he said. He sat with me now. Taught me how to hold it, strum it, and pluck it a little. Learn how to play, you're going to love it. One day, Gus heard me playing Malaguera, Gueno, and he nodded. Then he said something I'll never forget.
I think you're getting the hang.
No.
That's what Gus said to Keith. Gus is Keith's grandfather.
After that, I took the guitar everywhere. I went to sleep with it in my arms. It was wrapped around me. Even today, all these years later, I think of Gus every time I walk on stage, every time I write a song, every time I reach for a guitar and play a few dinka-plinks for my own grandchildren, I say to myself, thanks, Granddad. Thanks, Gus.